Should Pennsylvania get out of the booze business? And how would that affect you, not only when it comes to buying alcohol, but also balancing the state budget? It is the top story on News 8 at 5:30. Good evening. I'm Janelle Stelson.
And I'm Brian Roach. Some state lawmakers favor a plan to sell the state-owned wine and spirit stores to help close the budget shortfall. But the plan is already running into opposition. 8 on Your Side government reporter Matt Belanger is live with what state lawmakers had to say today. Matt?
Yeah, Brian, Janelle, good evening to you both. This is a complex issue, and it's come up many times before in Harrisburg. The idea here, though, no matter what side of the issue you're on, there seems to be agreement that it's gaining traction at the Capitol this time because of the state's desperate financial situation and the possibility privatizing the state's wine and spirit stores could help to close the state's looming budget shortfall. Now, the state-owned system in Pennsylvania has been law ever since Prohibition ended in the 1930s, and since then, state government has controlled the sale of wine and spirits. Supporters of privatization say, in addition to helping with the state budget, it could also lead to lower prices and maybe more convenience for customers through competition. Opponents warn the move could lead to more alcohol-related crime and accidents and possibly take away a yearly source of income for the state. The PLCB, as it exists, does produce revenue for the state each year. To give you just a flavor of how this proposal was received tonight at a state Senate hearing, here's just one senator's reaction.
The system's not broke. What is all this craziness? We're involved in a crisis in the state with so many other critical issues, and the biggest issue right now we're arguing about is the state store system. It's nonsensical to me.
And, of course, one of the other big questions is, will the state get the estimated $1 to $2 billion, some say the state could get from selling licenses and taxing alcohol going this privatization route? That, of course, is not a guarantee. And I can pretty much guarantee you this is not last call on this issue at the state capitol. That's our story live tonight in Harrisburg. Back to you.
All right, Matt. Thank you.